Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I wanted to show you a couple of examples where we use a weighted mean. And that just means that different data values have different weights. And we can compute that weighted mean, or x bar, by looking at the sum of all of the weights times the number of x that contain that weight, and then dividing by the total number of w. So if we're looking at GPA, and let's say we took a statistics course worth 5 credits and we got a B. And up here it tells us that a B is equal to 3 points. English 102, also 5 credits, we got a C, that would be equal to 2 points. A B is 3, a C is 2, D is 1, so forth. And there's more grades in there, of course, that we, if we had a plus or a minus, but just to keep it simple. Keyboarding is 2, human relations is 3. Notice that the different credits have then a different weight on your GPA, because something that has 5 credits is going to affect your GPA more. So to calculate that, we're just going to take the value of the grade, so that's 3.0, times the number of credits, 3.0 times 5, 2.0 times 5. An A is 4.0, but there was 2 credits of that, and then 3.0 times 3. And then we look at the total number of credits attempted, and that was 15. And we would just add all that up and divide by 15 to get 2.8. So you certainly could use your calculator to do that. If you were using your calculator, you could put the value of the grades in, and then for frequency, you could put the credits that you have in there. And I have a video showing you how to use your calculator if you have different numbers of frequency. And you can also do that in your StatCrunch program. Okay, so the other example is this one. What is your grade in a class? So if your grade is comprised of homework, quizzes, midterm, project, and a final, and you know what percent you get on each of those things, what would your grade be? Well, this is a weighted mean, and this is how many people run their classrooms. And if you're using Canvas, those usually have a percentage that's attached to each type of thing, homework or quiz. And so if the homework is 25%, the quizzes are 15%. So even if you think about your grade out of 100, if you got 100% on all your quizzes, that would contribute 15 points towards your final grade. If you got 100% on all your homework, that would contribute 25 points to the total grade, that is 100 points. So that's what that means. The midterm project being 20% of your grade says if you do the best possible on this, you can add 20 points towards your final grade. If you got a 50%, you would add 10 points. So that's what that means when you're looking at it. And it tells you here you got 80% on your homework, 75% on quizzes, 68% on your midterm, 87% on your project, and 82% on your final. So what's your grade in the class, assuming that a 60 to 69 is a D, 70 to 79 is a C, and so forth? Well, that calculation looks like very similar to what you may have done before. We're taking 25%, that's 25% of the overall grade, and you got 80% of that. So we're going to take all that up, set 25 times 80, 15 times 75, and so forth. And that gave me 78.65. And I didn't change the percentages here into percentages because I wanted you to get the idea of it's based out of 100 points. So if you think about 80% out of that, you can think of it that way. And when we're finished doing that calculation, you say, oh, I got 78.65 points out of a possible 100 points. If you want to think about that as a percentage, then you would just move that decimal point over 2 places. 0.865 would say, oh, I'm, you know, as a decimal, excuse me, 0.865. And as a percent, it's 78.65. So either way you look at it, we have a grade that's in the C range. And then if we want to round that to the tenths, you'd have a 78.7, which would be a C. So this is sort of the percent grade, this would be the decimal grade, and that would put you at a C. What if you all you had left was your final exam, but you knew all the other grades in the class, but you didn't know how you did on that final, you haven't taken it yet. What's the best you could do in the class, and what's the worst you could do? Well, this is a question I get from students a lot. What do I have to get on the final to get a C? What do I have to get on the final to get a B? This is something you have control of calculating if all you have left is the final exam. The best you could do on the final would be 100%, and that would give you 20 points toward adding on to your grade. And the worst is you didn't take the final, you got zero, then you wouldn't add any of that, right? So if you look at it this way, if you had, you knew everything but the final, you could say, well, the best I can do is I could get 100 points on that final, or 100% of that final, if you want to think about it in percentages. And then that would give me, add 20 points onto my grade at, along with everything else I already had. And that shows you that you could get an 82.25 in that class. That would be percent, or think about it as points out of 100 is what I'm showing it as. And then you could also get a zero on that test, and that means you didn't get to add any of those 20 points on, so the 62.25 would be the worst you could do. So if you got a 50%, you might be able to see that you'd be at 72%, right? So that's how that works. You can figure out what your overall grade might be in class if you understand how to calculate a weighted mean. And again, these points are showing you, you would have 82.25 points out of a possible 100, the 100 coming from 100%. That's the best you could do in the class. All right, have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.